Most about South Carolina. They're in the midst of probably one of their best seasons ever as a program.
Well, I think they play together, play as a team, and they run the basketball. They score a lot out of transition. They play to their strengths. So I think that's a positive for them.
Just obviously, it's going to be a challenge dealing with their inside game, even with Izzy, but without. Just how much of a challenge does that present? Those players they've got.
Yeah, I think they like to play the game inside out, and we're going to have to. You know, we're have to be solid in there. We've done it. We've defended against people bigger than us. We've defended with Izzy out, sitting on the bench in foul trouble. So we've just got to do it as a team. We're going to play in front, play behind. We're going to do a lot of different things to try to disrupt them.
You know, after the Alabama game, Sarah was kind of joking around. Everybody's written y'all off, crossed off the map. Man, since Notre Dame, y'all really haven't been in a situation where you've been underdogs. It's kind of a role y'all are kind of liking in a way?
I think this team likes to be the underdog. And, I think people have written us off. That's all I've heard is Izzy's out and, we're pretty much done. But this is a solid team. And they've worked really hard to get to the level they're at. So I think we're all excited to get there and play the game.
Holly, do you have an idea of who you might start on Monday? You kind of intimated that lineup the other night was a bit of an experiment.
No, Bashar will go back in the lineup. I'm not sure the other ones, but I know Bashar will be there. And I don't. We're seeing if we want to go guard heavy or we want to go bigger than the post. So we'll probably hopefully make that decision today.
In games here, when you've had your full complement, you've been inclined to maybe put two or three subs in at a time in the first. Are you going to have to maybe be a little more selective about how you substitute?
I think our substitution will be according to how the game's going. Are we tired? Are we needing a sub? I don't anticipate us putting in probably three at a time. I think we've got to go solid with a core group. And then if somebody needs a breather, get them a breather and then get back into what we feel is a solid core group for us.
Do you feel good about these kids if in a game like this, if some of them have to play 34, 35 minutes?
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, I think we're in great shape. I think that if we had to, I think our starting, I think we could play, some of them could play close to 40 minutes. Not everybody, but some. Depends on how the game is, how physical it is, how up and down it is. But I think I've got to be real mindful of our timeouts and use the media timeouts as well.
You know, your shooting percentage has kind of been up and down in games, but you've had good shooting games. I mean, the Notre Dame game comes to mind. How important is it going to be what kind of a percentage do you have in mind that we need to shoot around this if we want to stay with these guys? Because they shoot it pretty well, looks like.
Yeah, I think we got to shoot up in the upper 40s. I mean, I think we got to shoot the ball well. I don't think we need to get, I don't know how they're going to play us because usually people have been packing it in on Izzy. They may get out and get after us. I'm not sure. But all I care about, Dan, is us getting quality shots. Not number one, not quick shooting the basketball. We cannot afford to do that. And getting a quality shot, which means a shot that's makeable for you. Mm-hmm. So I think when we recognize those two things, I think we'll be fine.
Do you think these kids are aware of, mindful of, in that regard of getting to the free throw line, if they're taking shots that might, if they're not making and getting, because,
this team. We talk about that a lot. Yeah. And I think we've gotten to the free throw line a lot more than we have last year, and I feel good about their recognizing, do I need to penetrate, do I need to catch and shoot.
How is Jordan health-wise?
She's great. She's good.
How has she developed? I know this was kind of a year where you want her to step up and play point, especially for next year when Massengale's not here. How has she developed, and is she where you want her to be?
I think Jordan is, yes. I think Jordan's been a great leader for us. Outside of her ability to play the game, I think she's been a solid, great leader for us. Very vocal, getting people where they need to go. She brings energy, and when she brings energy and shows energy, it kind of trickles down to our team. But I think she's doing a great job.
You talked about Bashar moving back into the starting lineup. How critical is she going to be, especially with Izzy out?
Well, I think for us, Bashar and all of us, I think that it's not so much that she does offensive defense. I think for us, it's keeping them off the boards. I think that's a big key for us is trying not to allow them to get second, third chance points. But I think Bashar, she's such a competitor, and I just have a good feel that she's going to step up and play as hard as she can for this team.
You mentioned rebounding. If a team like South Carolina that is so good at rebounding, do your guards have to crash down to help out on the defensive end of rebounding, and does that hurt your fast break opportunities?
Well, defensively, we've got to have five people boxing out. And I think South Carolina is one of the best at going to the boards offensively. So it's going to be a team effort. Really, truly, it's going to be a team effort. Could we get our guards rebounding more on the offensive end? Absolutely. Absolutely. Get us second, third chance points. But I think I'm probably more concerned with them rebounding offensively more so than us.
How valuable has Jamie's Nard been, especially when she can play down low a little bit and when you guys are maybe a little shorter there in the paint than you would like with Izzy?
Well, I think Jamie has stepped her game up, and you're seeing the Jamie Nard that we've seen. It's given a lot of people a break that from the starters, but I think that Jamie's a competitor, and when she goes in and gets big rebounds, takes big shots, she's becoming a better defender for us, and that's what we need. I just think her all-around game is really evolving to be a really nice player for us, and we need her. She's stepping up at a great time for us.
There are still several more games after this in SEC play, but this one would just about, as most people would say, decide who's going to be the number one seed heading into the SEC tournament. Is it difficult to motivate your team, or is that very easy to get them up because they understand that?
You know what? They're not even thinking about a number one seed. They're just thinking about playing South Carolina, and they're the underdog, and they want to take care of business. So I don't have to motivate them too. I don't have to use a lot of motivation tactics this game.
At key moments for big games this year, you seem to have hit that theme about their effort, about their competitiveness.
Yep.
Do you feel like you need to revisit that before this game, or maybe that's not necessary given the circumstances?
No, I don't. I think their effort's going to be there. If our last couple of practices have been any indication, we should be fine, because we've been very attentive, very focused, and have played really, really hard the last 2 days of practice.
Obviously, they've added some big pieces this last season. What's the biggest difference in seeing what they're doing as a team this year versus maybe the last couple of years?
Well, you just said it. I think adding Aja Wilson makes the team that much better. I mean, the number one player in the country and is from Columbia. I just think it brings you positive energy of what she can do, and it's got the fans interested too. I think that's huge for them. I think getting people to come out brings their team energy as well. But they're a year older. The ones that were there a year older, so they've got to be better, or that staff's not doing their job, and they are better.
What's the key to staying poised in front of an environment that might hold maybe 15 to 20,000 tomorrow night?
It's just playing like you did in front of Rutgers. It's playing like you did in front of Notre Dame. You play the game. And I think what's been really good about our schedule is we put our players in that environment. And we've seemed to handle it really, really well. So I would be real nervous if we have not played away from here in that environment, but we have. So I feel pretty confident that they'll be able to handle the noise in the crowd.